For years and years, I've heard about fights for ancestral lands. It's happened in many parts of Latin America, in Brazil, in Paraguay, in Argentina, in Chile as well. But I felt I needed to really understand what is going on in southern Chile. This is the only place in Latin America where today you see an indigenous group openly fighting for the land. I am not necessarily worried. I just don't know how it's going to end. I'm Latin American correspondent Lucia Newman, and between us, it's not an easy story to cover. The Araucania region is beautiful. It's vast. It has volcanoes, lakes, rivers. It's also the area where the Mapuches have been living for hundreds and hundreds of years. I had never met or had friends who were Mapuche when I was growing up. I didn't know what they were like because there's a complete segregation in this country between rich and poor, between Mapuche and everybody else. What separates you is your poverty, where you live, and the prejudices that you may have about them. And Mapuche means people of the land, people of the earth. They've been living in this part of the world for much more than 500 years, long before the Spanish conquistadors came here and tried to conquer them. In the last couple of decades, there's been a reawakening of the Mapuche culture. I never saw Mapuches dressed as Mapuches, wearing their ponchos, their headbands, their jewelry, their earrings. Now you see it absolutely everywhere. There's this pride that they hadn't felt for who knows how long. The women are becoming more and more the leaders of this movement. They really have courage, they have guts.
Nosotros somos Mapuche y no nos avergonzamos de eso.
The only other ethnic group that live in the Araucania region are the white Chileans. They believe that they have got as much right to live there as the Mapuches. It's very, very difficult to imagine how you can divide all this up now. Who gets what? Who has more rights to it? That is really the basis of the conflict. Things have gotten so out of hand in what some people view as the Wild West. We are seeing younger Mapuches forming other organizations that are much more impatient, that are willing to use violence against people or areas. So they're burning down the forests, they're burning the machinery that belongs to the forestry companies, and they're taking over that land. They're clearing the land and trying to see if they can make it fertile and grow again. Chile's forestry industry are continuing to plant huge amounts of pine trees and eucalyptus trees, which are not native to the region and which suck up the water and in the end poisons the soil. The CAM is probably the largest and certainly the oldest resistance movement by Mapuches that want to take back their ancestral land. One of my Chilean colleagues' loss was actually my gain because he was attacked, ambushed with his cameraman shortly after having met with Hector Yaitul, the leader of the CAM, by another group. When I finally met the famous Hector Yaitul, I really felt that we were measuring each other up the whole time. He had to basically trust me that I wasn't setting him up. This is a man who has been on the run for almost all of his life. He has been accused of murder, sabotage acts.
¡Viva la lucha al pueblo mapuche!
He rarely gave interviews.
Esa es una realidad en Chile. Aquí nosotros, como pueblo nación mapuche, luchamos contra un Estado que es un Estado, por definición, capitalista, de formato colonial, ¿ya? Racista e intolerante con la causa mapuche.
The Mapuches want their ancestral leaders to be respected and recognized by the Chilean state. Chile's current constitution doesn't recognize even the existence of indigenous people, as do the constitutions of just about every other country in the Americas. Chile's going to have a new constitution, and one of the items is to allow delegates to be guaranteed for the country's indigenous populations. The playing field is so uneven that at least then they would have a voice in rewriting the new constitution. There are candidates from different groups, the Rapa Nui, who live on Easter Island, the Aymara, who live in northern Chile, but the largest number of delegates will be, of course, from the Mapuches, who make up the largest indigenous population of Chile. If this new constitution can at least recognize them as an entity with their own rights, that could be the first step towards regional autonomy, or at least communal autonomy, recognition of their leaders, of their customs, their language. Their voices must be heard.